हाँ जी, गुड इवनिंग टू यू ऑल. वेलकम टू एडुटैप. सो इफ़ यू आई कैन सी मैनी ऑफ यू हियर, यू जस्ट नीड टू टेल मी दैट आई एम ऑडिबल इनफ, यू कैन सी द स्क्रीन एंड देन विल बिगिन विद द सेशन. ओके प्लीज़, आई विल बी वेटिंग फॉर यू गाइज टू राइट. Okay, so Nilesh is here, Divya is here, Rajendra is also here. Rajendra has some concerns. Rajendra, I'll take your concerns after the lecture, because I can see the concerns are not related to this particular lecture. जी, ये ई पी एफ ओ के लिए नहीं है, दिस इज़ फॉर सेबी ग्रेड ए 2020. तो मीन वाइल आई टेल यू वॉट दिस लेक्चर सीरीज इज़ ऑल अबाउट. सी, फॉर सेबी ग्रेड ए 2020 वी आर डिस्कसिंग वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम करंट अफेयर्स पार्ट. करंट अफेयर्स बेसिकली डज नॉट इंक्लूड ओनली करंट अफेयर्स क्वेश्चन, बट ऑल्सो द कम्प्लीट जी ए कॉम्पोनेंट इज बींग हैंडल्ड थ्रू दिस पर्टिकुलर सीरीज, बिकॉज वी कम अप विद क्वेश्चन लाइक क्वेश्चन रिलेटेड टू फाइनेंशियल अवेयरनेस, देन वी ऑल्सो कवर क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम स्टैटिक पार्ट of GA. So all in all, we have conducted 13 lectures till now. This is our 14th lecture, and most of you have seen the lectures, most of the lectures due to the lockdown. We started this live session series but had to go back to recorded videos, but now it's fine. Now we are starting with the live sessions again. Today's lecture is all about the revision. So Jan to April current affairs would be discussed in this session. Okay. I can see that you guys are asking, will SEBI phase 1 be postponed? See, as of now, we cannot comment. You should prepare, considering your exam to take place in July month only, okay? If it gets postponed, then it will be not a big problem for you, because you have prepared really well, right? You will get additional time. So, without wasting time, I'll get back to the lecture quickly. Just a disclaimer, guys, as you can see the setup, the video is not being recorded from the studio or the office. So this is my home. I hope that you guys understand that if any issue arises, please let me know and ignore as such if it is ignorable, and focus on the lecture. Okay. Akash, you are saying but they are giving no response. Akash, I'll get back to you for sure. Okay. I'll tell you the details also how to contact us. ठीक है, लेट्स स्टार्ट. सो आर रिजल्ट्स, प्रीवियस रिजल्ट्स, एडुटैप हैज़ ब्रिलियंट रिजल्ट्स विद अस. 2019 नाबार्ड आरबीआई, देन 2018 नाबार्ड आरबीआई सेबी, सेबी टुक प्लेस इन 2018. वी हैव ब्रिलियंट रिजल्ट्स विद अस. आई होप यू फील कॉन्फिडेंट आफ्टर सीइंग द रिजल्ट दैट यू आर गेटिंग द राइट गाइडेंस. यू जस्ट नीड टू फोकस. एंड अनदर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इन्फॉर्मेशन, वी आर रनिंग अ डिस्काउंट ऑफ 30%, सेबी 30. दिस इज द कूपन कोड यू हैव टू यूज, सेबी 30, एंड यू कैन अवेल द डिस्काउंट. ओके, so I'll be taking you to question number 1. We have around 35 questions to be discussed today. I hope if you have been through the previous lectures, this lecture is going to be real fun for you, because it'll be kind of a testing session for you, wherein I'll see that the questions already discussed, are you able to retain those questions, and I'll be giving you less time today, okay, because the questions have been discussed somewhere, be it lecture 1, 2, I do not say that recent ones, but all the important current affairs from Jan, Feb, March, April would be discussed. Okay, let's start then. Which of the following state or UTs has hosted the 26th International Yoga Festival recently? So in January, this yoga festival took place. You have to tell me the city, the state or UT where has this taken place. New Delhi, Puducherry, Gujarat, Maharashtra or Jammu and Kashmir. So come up with the answer quickly, guys. Puducherry and New Delhi. Okay. For the students who have joined in just now, let me tell you, we are going to discuss, we are going to revise the most important questions from Jan to April. Puducherry I'm getting, and one answer was there with, who is going with New Delhi. The answer to the question is Puducherry. So 26th International Yoga Festival has been organized in Puducherry in the month of January. Sebastian Kurz has been recently elected as world's youngest democratically elected government head. He is the head of which of the following nations? So Sebastian Kurz is associated with Hungary, Slovakia, Poland, Austria or Czech Republic. जितने भी questions हैं आप please questions बाद में लेकर आइए, I'll really appreciate that. अभी यहाँ पे focus करते हैं. लद्दाख is it? Ladakh is not the I hope there's a lag. I can see the questions, previous questions answer. Okay. Austria, Rajendra says. Quick guys, quick. And if you have not seen the previous lectures, go and see them also. Today's lecture is based on the hand-picked questions from previous current affairs. Austria, Akash, Rajendra. Shakti is saying Slovakia. So I can see Slovakia and Austria. Are the two options you guys are going with? Austria is the answer. So Sebastian Kurz is associated with Austria. He is the world's youngest democratically elected head of any government. Okay. Which of the following has assumed office of the CDS recently in January 2020? Yes, this is also important. Chief of Defence Staff. Chief of Defence Staff is associated with another important department also that I'll be talking in next question. So, Chief of Defence Staff, very easy. Satendra Kumar Saini, Rakesh Singh Badhoria, Bipin Rawat, Manoj Mukund Naravane or Karambir Singh. Bipin Rawat, Akash is the first one to answer. Akash and Rajendra are the first ones to answer. Guys, please come up with the answers quickly. Nilesh Saurabh, all going with Bipin Rawat? That's correct. Bipin Rawat is now the Chief of Defence Staff. Next question. Department of Military Affairs has been created by Defence Ministry recently. Who will be the head of this department? So this is an easy question. I've given hint already. It is again related to Chief of Defence Staff. So answer here would be Chief of Defence Staff, which is Bipin Rawat. See, you have to understand that Department of Military Affairs is going to be headed by Chief of Defence Staff, which is currently Bipin Rawat. So you have to understand that if Bipin Rawat is not the Chief of Defence Staff, then some other person is going to head it, because the department is to be headed by CDS current. Okay. Rocky Johnson has passed away in January 2020. He was associated with which of the following sports? This is a typical question of SEBI. Important sports personalities, be it national or international, they ask that this personality is associated with which sport. So Rocky Johnson was a very famous weightlifter, wrestler, gymnast, shooter or athlete. Which sports was he associated with? I can see many of you have joined in. Welcome guys. Question fifth is this one. You have to answer. We are discussing current affairs from Jan to April. Handpicked most important questions. Rajendra is again the first one to answer wrestling. Mangesh also answered. Surbhi and Shakti. Wrestling, all of you are confident. That's right. Wrestling. Recently, Daniel Arap Moi has passed away. He was the longest serving president of Kenya. What is the capital of Kenya? So two takeaways. First of all, you have to know that this personality, Daniel Arap Moi, is associated with Kenya, right? Second, the static part comes in, because general awareness includes static parts. Static parts, the most basic questions are the capitals and currencies of different nations and states also, okay? Even states, yes. These can be asked. What is the capital of different states or UTs in India, and then international also? So capital of Kenya is Nairobi. Nairobi is a very famous place when it comes to international organizations, because I think it is the headquarter of UNEP, United Nations Environment Program, I guess. You can confirm it once. ठीक है आगे चलें. Who among the following has been selected as the central banker of the year Asia Pacific for 2020 in February 2020? So Feb question, very important. Don't tell me anyone that you do not know the answer. I want all of you to answer. Central banker of the year Asia Pacific. Shakti has confirmed it's UNEP. Thank you. Now answer this question. Central Banker of the Year, Asia Pacific. Very easy guys, this has been in news a lot. Yes, it is Shakti Kanta Das. So Reserve Bank of India's head has been selected as Central Banker of the Year for Asia Pacific region, Shakti Kanta Das. Which one of the following cities has hosted BIMSTEC DM exercise 2020 in February? So disaster management exercise for BIMSTEC has taken place in India. You have to tell the place where it was organized. You see, all questions are important. Hurry up, guys. We have to cover a lot of questions today. 35 questions. New Delhi, is it? Vishakhapatnam, A, 1. All of you going with 1? Nahi. Mixed responses. Vishakhapatnam, Bhubaneswar, New Delhi. You guys are confused. Okay. So the ones who answered Bhubaneswar, they are correct. This exercise has taken place in Odisha. Bhubaneswar. Okay. BIMSTEC, you have to... This is very important. Do find out the acronym of BIMSTEC and mention in the comment section below. This is your task of the day, guys. Please, you have to do this because we also want to know that students who are engaged with us, they are also paying their attention. So BIMSTEC, you have to find out the acronym and mention in the comments. Chalo, aage. Who among the following is the author of Message from Messengers book launched in Feb 2020? Again, a typical question. There was a question on... There are the important books which are there. Jhokha Alharti, a book she wrote that was asked in the examination. I think RBI and NABARD last year. So these questions are important related to latest books. So Message from Messengers has been written by Arundhati Roy, Jasper Lahiri, Vikram Seth, Preeti K. Shroff or Amish Tripathi. Preeti Shroff is the answer. That's correct. Very nice, guys. Option 4. Which of the following railway zones has become first on Indian Railways to come up with the concept of energy neutral railway stations? Again, this is important. So, first zone of Indian Railways to come up with the concept of energy neutral. We have covered the concept of carbon negative, if you remember. The carbon neutral is one thing. Carbon negative is basically taking the carbon from atmosphere and storing it. Basically, minus the carbon from the atmosphere. So similarly, energy neutral railway station is going to be here, and it has been brought up by South Central. That's right. Northern Railways is not the answer. South Central. Which one of the following scholars has won the prestigious Dan David Prize in February? So in Feb, this prize was given. Answer is Geeta Sen, Tarabai Shinde, Kamla Bhaseen, Urvashi Bhutalia or Durgabai Deshmukh. So this Dan David Prize has gone to Geeta Sen, option 1. This is the picture I have brought so that, because see, important personalities are important, but when you see them, probably it becomes easy for you to recall. So Dan David Prize is associated with Geeta Sen. The picture is here. Which one of the following movies has recently received 92nd Oscar Award for Best Film category? Very easy question and a very important one. So, 92nd Oscar Award. Had our exam taken place in April, phase 1. This question was to be asked, sure shot. Oscar Award, because it just came in the like mid of February, but still it is important. Okay, so answer is Parasite. Yes, I hope you must have seen this movie. If not, do not see it now. Focus on your studies. Who among the following has been recently named as EY Entrepreneur of the Year 2020? So EY is Ernest Young. This company has come up with the award of Entrepreneur of the Year, and the award has gone to Vijay Shekhar Sharma, no. Ritesh Agarwal, no. Shraddha Sharma, no. Deep Kalra, no. Kiran Majumdar Shaw is the answer. And she is associated with Biocon. It's a biotech startup, and this is the personality. She has worked really hard, and today she's got this award. Kiran Majumdar Shaw. She's a very famous name when it comes to biotechnology. Biocon is the company which she is associated with. Who among the following has won Best Actress Award during 65th Filmfare Awards ceremony? Bhumi Padnekar, Kareena Kapoor, Tapsee Pannu, Deepika Padukone or Alia Bhatt. This is also easy. A movie was very much in news. Not in news, I would say it became very famous because of its rap, singing and all. So I think you know the answer. Alia Bhatt, yes. So Alia Bhatt won this award for Gully Boy, and Ranveer Singh for Gully Boy. He was the best actor. Alia Bhatt was best actress. Filmfare Awards. These are also very important. Which one of the following states has recently hosted Sampriti, a joint military exercise between India and Bangladesh? So Sampriti 9th, as you can see this 9th, this is the 9th edition. So Sampriti, first of all you have to know, is a joint exercise, military exercise between India and Bangladesh, okay? And secondly, where has it taken place? This is also important. This becomes static. Sampriti is an exercise, like Surya Kiran is an exercise between India and Nepal. So such exercises are important. We usually cover them, right? Are you able to recall some other exercises also? Like Sampriti is for Bangladesh, Surya Kiran for Nepal. Meghalaya, correct. That's the right answer. Tell me if some of the exercises, you are a bilateral exercise, you are able to recall. Hurry up guys, come on. Two I've told you, Sampriti and Surya Kiran. Any other bilateral exercise? Very nice. I was expecting Yuddha Vyas. Yuddha Vyas is between India and Mitra Shakti is also there. Correct. Sahyog Kajan. Great. Ajay Warrior. UK. Nice. Hand in Hand. China. Milan in Vishakhapatnam. Very nice guys. Really very good. You know all these things. Ajay Warrior, UK, India, that's correct. Great. China, everyone is able to recall nowadays. China is in, is the common word, is it? Chalo, theek hai. Reserve Bank of India has announced in February 2020 that it would launch a digital payment index by Dash. So, a very important thing. Digital payment index is going to be released by whom? Reserve Bank of India. First, second, when? So probably it also might get postponed, okay, like your exam, as it got from April to July. Let's hope it does not get postponed again, but still, DPI is going to be released by July 2020. This is very easy to recall. Your exam is scheduled to take place in July. At that time only RBI will come up with its DPI. RBI has decided to observe a financial literacy week from Feb 10 to 15. What is the theme of this week? So yes, financial literacy week is organized by Reserve Bank of India. Three takeaways. Listen to me carefully. Financial literacy week organized by Reserve Bank of India. Second, the dates. When was it organized? Second week of February. So 10 to 15. Then theme. Theme is very important. Make in India, PSBs, rural banking, MSMEs, or none of the above. All are important, but what was the theme this time? MSMEs, yes. MSMEs are already playing a very important role. You see, in the present situation, the most impacted sector is being considered to be MSMEs, and they are being provided a push. SIDBI came up with a scheme to provide a push to MSMEs to provide them loan, because MSME sector is very important in terms of employment as well as the share they hold in terms of growth. Who among the following has been appointed as Chief Information Commissioner of India? You see, all questions are very important. We have come to March month. Jan-Feb questions we have done. So, Chief Information Commissioner of India is Bimal Julka. Yes, here is the picture of Sir Bimal Julka. He is the Chief Information Commissioner of India. See, these are basic GA questions. Very, very important for SEBI Grade A 2020, and when I get the questions that are these important for other exams also, then you have to refer to the syllabus of your exam. If GA is a part of it, then and such questions are asked in your examination, obviously it will be helpful, because for SEBI these are asked, these are the type of questions asked. You have to decide that for any exam if you are preparing for, are the questions which are similar to such asked in that examination, then it will be important. Which one of the following cities has organized Khelo India Winters Game in March? Thank you for answering, Rajendra, BIMSTEC. But now come to question number 17. Khelo India Winters Game, Gulmarg, in a very wintry place, it has taken place, Leh. Which Indian exchange is going to launch gas trading platform, Indian Gas Exchange? So yes, an exchange has announced that Indian Gas Exchange would be set up. Who will launch this platform? NSE, BSE, MCX, IEX, or none of the above? It is easy if you know the full forms of these basic exchanges, because we have covered all these things, but you should know if you are preparing for SEBI, National Stock Exchange, Bombay Stock Exchange, Multi Commodity Exchange, or Indian Energy Exchange. So Energy Exchange would be the answer if you know that a gas trading platform is going to take place. No, it's not MCX. No, no, no. IEX is the answer. Prateek, note it down, please. No, Akash, not BSE, IEX. Most of you are going wrong. So IEX is the answer, option 4. World Sparrow Day is observed on 20th March every year. Its theme for the year 2020 is very easy theme. First of all, World Sparrow Day is observed on 20th March. This is important for you guys as a static part. Second theme. Very easy theme. I love sparrows. Yes. So if you love sparrows, you'll never forget it. And if you do not, then start loving them, because this is the theme of World Sparrow Day, which can be asked in the examination. Very nice. Many of you have joined in. That's really nice. Chalo, question 20th. In those who are late, do not worry. We are on question 20th. You have missed many questions, but you can see the recorded video later on. So the government has notified the Constitution of National Company Law Appellate Tribunal Bench at DASH. This is very important. NCLAT has been decided, has been notified to be constituted at Chennai is the answer, NCLAT. Very nice. This is again a very important question. A skill development program for women called as DigiPivot has been launched by. This is again a very important question. All the questions, hand-picked ones. Skill development program for women has been launched by Microsoft, Google India, Facebook, Flipkart, or none of the above. Google India has come up with DigiPivot. So basically, skill development program. This is for women, and DigiPivot is the name. They are going to provide skills, develop skills for women so that they can come up as women entrepreneurs. Which among the following Indian institutions has framed regulatory guidance for Indian accounting standards, INDAS, for implementing NBFCs and ARCs? So moving to the answer, the very basic thing underlying, which is easy, but in exam you can be confused. So NBFC stand for what? Non-banking finance companies. ARC stand for what? Asset reconstruction companies. INDAS stands for what? Indian Accounting Standards. Three acronyms I've given you from this one question. Okay, coming to the answer. Regulatory guidance for INDAS has been made by ICAI, ICSI, AMFI, SEBI, RBI. NBFCs, ARCs, the most common word associated with RBI. Correct. I am glad you knew the answer. No. It's not ICAI. It's Reserve Bank. See, regulatory guidance would be provided by the regulatory body, right? And NBFCs, whenever you see ARCs, who is the regulatory body? Reserve Bank of India. That is the answer. It's not SEBI. I know it might be confusing, but it's not. Next question. Tony Lewis, one of the man behind Duckworth-Lewis Stern, has passed away. This term, Duckworth-Lewis Stern, is related to which of the following sports? Basketball, golf, football, cricket. Badminton. So what is the answer? Duckworth-Lewis Stern, this term is associated with cricket. I hope those who are cricket enthusiasts must know this answer. I was personally not aware about it, so it is a very kind of difficult term for me, but please recall this. Duckworth-Lewis turn method is associated with cricket. Why is this method used? Like, what is it associated with? Can anyone tell here? I would wait for few seconds if I get any answer, or else I'll move forward, or else I'll Google and check it later. If anyone knows, please tell me. Acha, run decide target it is. Okay, thank you so much, Priyanka, Rajendra, Aisha, thank you. I hope those who did not know about this term earlier are now aware. They are saying it is related to the revised target in terms of uncertain circumstances, like to basically revise the target of the team who is chasing, I guess, the target, or both. Acha, both the teams. Theek hai. Recently, Philip Anderson has passed away. He's a Nobel Prize winner under which one of the categories? So, Philip Anderson is associated with medicine, chemistry, physics, economics, or literature. A Nobel Prize winner. Theek hai, okay, come to this question. Thank you so much, guys. Thank you. You have made me well aware about this method now. So Philip Anderson was associated with physics. He was a Nobel Prize winner in the subject physics. This is the picture of Mr. Philip Anderson. In April 2020, government has notified FPIs from DASH is eligible for taking up Category 1 licenses. So two categories, broad categories, a rejig was done. So two broad categories are there, Category 1 and Category 2. So it's easy for Category 1 to get the licenses. Which one of the following FPIs are now the Category 1 country from where they are? They would be Category 1. Mauritius, USA, Japan, Germany, none of the above. Saurabh is the first one to answer. Mauritius, great. That is the right answer. Very, very important question for every exam you are preparing for related to banking. Interest rate on PPF has been reduced to what percent from 7.9%? So PPF interest rate has been reduced. Earlier it was 7.9. Now it is 7.1%. This you must know. And even the interest on NSC, National Savings Certificate, has been reduced. That was 7.1. It has now been made 6.8, I guess. So that's it. Next question. Which one of the following is an initiative launched by association representing officers of central civil services to support the government's effort in fighting coronavirus? It's a very interesting name, and it's a very important initiative taken by the civil servants. That's okay, Rajendra. Probably there can be some issues related to network, but I am getting to see your answer. Do not worry. So the initiative which has been launched by the Central Civil Services Officers Association is Karuna. It is very nice. Karuna is the name of this association, and Karuna is an acronym in itself. It stands for Civil Services Association's reach to support in natural disasters. So this is what Karuna stands for. Who among the following has been elected as the new chief of UK's Labour Party? This is also important. Edward Miliband, Preeti Patel, Clive Lewis, Tony Blair, or Keir Starmer? Karuna. Santosh, I am not able to get your query. Please come up with the query. Just 7-8 questions left. So, new chief of UK's Labour Party. When India got independence from UK, at that time, Labour Party was in the power. So, just an added fact I'm telling you. Answer is Keir Starmer. Yes, I can see some of the answers and that's right. He has replaced Jeremy Corbyn. Okay, Jeremy Corbyn replaced by Keir Starmer as the chief of UK's Labour Party. World Health Day has been observed on 7th April. Its theme for the year 2020 is very important. Health Day is very important. Sparrow Day, 20th March, we have seen. But Health Day in the current pandemic going on. 7th April is the day on which it is observed. And you will be able to relate. If you do not know, let me tell you. It will be very easy for you to recall this. The very important role being played in today's situation is by doctors and nurses and health workers. So nurses, support nurses and midwives is the theme of this year. Option 3. Reserve Bank of India has announced Operation Dash to soften long-term yields. So which operation was organized, was announced by Reserve Bank of India? This is actually the second edition of this particular operation. Sonam has informed us that WHO 2020 year of midwives, nurses and midwives. That is true. Achha, coming back to Reserve Bank of India's operation. Operation Twist. I will tell you, Suruchi, which month current affairs after the questions, please. In April 2020, Reserve Bank of India has announced a special liquidity facility for mutual funds of rupees dash crore. So, acha, this rupees is twice. Ignore this thing. Special liquidity facility for mutual funds has been announced by Reserve Bank of India. What is the amount of that liquidity facility? 50,000 crore. And yes, very important, do not get confused. This liquidity facility for mutual funds has not been announced by SEBI. Liquidity is dealt by Reserve Bank of India. So they have come up with this facility, okay? Very important. Second, the amount is 50,000 crore. Okay, very quick. Amazon Pay has launched a dash which will extend a virtual line of credit to eligible customers shopping on Amazon.in. This is also important. Amazon is doing really well in term in the current situation, and its owner is going to become a very rich man, Jeff Bezos. So Amazon Pay has launched this virtual kind of credit line called as Amazon Pay Later. Option 4. Theek hai? A dash has designed schemes to provide liquidity support to MSME sector. This I discussed earlier, I mentioned it, I think. If you were attentive enough, you will be able to answer. SIDBI is the answer, yes. To provide liquidity support to MSME sector, SIDBI has come up with a particular scheme. Which one of the following countries has decided to form 21 member teams for talks with Taliban? Very easy again. Even if it was not in current, you must know that Taliban has been in news from, I don't know, many, many years. I don't even remember. But it has been in news a lot. Related to a particular country, our neighbor country, Taliban. Option 3, Afghanistan. So Taliban is associated with Afghanistan. Nahin, USA has not decided. Taliban, Afghanistan said the talk was organized in Doha. Afghanistan decided to do it, not USA. USA is busy in other things. Achha, last question. Adam Schlesinger has passed away. He was an Emmy award winning dash. Adam Schlesinger. Emmy award winning last question. This is, guys, come on, all of you answer this question please. 3, is it, Rajendra? musician. Adam Schlesinger was not a singer, he was a musician. Yes. No, director. Musician. Clear? So yes, we are done with the most important questions revision from Jan to April. When next time we meet, probably Monday, we'll meet at the same time, at the same channel, EduTap. Please subscribe the channel if you haven't done it yet. And we'll meet on Monday discussing new questions. Okay? So I will just wait to take up few queries which I was getting in between, okay? Because as I say that it is better that you come up with the queries at the end so that lecture does not get disrupted. So, kindly ask. You're welcome, Sonam. You're welcome, Nilesh, Prateek. Surbhi, there is already a playlist. Please find it out. All 13 lectures are there. This is the 14th. This will also go in the playlist. You're welcome, Aisha. Okay. A very difficult name. Thang Poi. Good night. Okay. Very nice. Surbhi, there is a playlist. Please check it. Acha, you mean all the initiatives which are going, which have been announced under this particular package, 20,000 crore wala. I will try to come up with something like that, okay? Okay, Pawan has the question and Suruchi, you both have the same question that what current affairs month? See, we say that 6 months current affairs are very important. Out of 6 months, 3 months just before the examination are the most important ones. So, in this case, if your exam is in July, April, May, June current affairs would be very important. But because of the current situation going on, many events, many important developments have not taken place. So I would suggest you to consider April, Jan, Feb, March also important and focus on April, May, June current affairs. Okay. Akash is saying, please give the contact number. See, this is the contact number 8146207241. If you're not able to reach us through number, probably because many students are calling, and if you're not able to reach us, just drop a mail at hello@edutap.co.in. You'll get a call back from us, okay? And to buy the course, you just need to go to the website www.edutap.co.in. You will have to select your course and then you can buy the course. Okay, Aisha, so how are you liking the course? How can I contact you? Aisha, you just need to drop a mail at hello@edutap.co.in. If you are a student of our course, then there is a facility of discussion forum. You can raise your query in the concerned section. For example, if you have a query related to general awareness, then write your query in that section. I will contact you from there. Thank you, Rajendra. You have watched all the lectures. Thank you so much. I hope you really find it helpful. My CA final exams there on 29th July. How to see? I think a lot of time you have got. You must have prepared everything now. So I am not able to comment on your other exam, but current affairs we have revised. You must have prepared earlier also. Reasoning classes are taken by Ratan ma'am and JV sir also. Okay, so theek hai, I'll wind up. I think all your queries have been answered. We'll meet up soon. Wishing you all the very best. Stay tuned and stay safe, guys. Okay, that is very important. Okay, I'll just sign off.